Hello everyone, welcome back to GK Code Labs. So in this video, I'm going to discuss a very important topic which will be very helpful for you in data engineering career and also in the data engineering interviews. So the concept is data pivoting. If you have worked a lot on MS Excel, you might be aware of what pivoting is, but how do we actually achieve that specifically in Apache Spark? That is what we are going to discuss in this video. People who have decent amount of experience in SQL might also know what pivoting is, and as a part of this video, we'll be seeing how do we do pivoting in Apache Spark data frames. And also, if you have no idea of pivoting, I have very simply explained what pivoting is, and with actual use case that clicked in my mind that pivoting is a very optimal approach to solve this particular use case. So this is a very interesting use case you should keep in mind. Might be interviewer can ask you, there can be direct or indirect questions that what is pivoting, or you might be given a use case to solve such kind of scenario where pivoting might be an optimal solution. So that particular use case I'm going to discuss in this video, and we'll also be discussing about pivoting. I'll be explaining in a very easy way. So let's check out what we have to discuss in this video. So this is the data that we have. This is a sample of insurance domain data. So similar relevant columns we have, you can see, like transaction ID, created date, method created by, some random fields, policy number, VIN, vehicle identification number, loss date, and there is some column as allocation rank. This is our basic data. Now let's see what we have to do on this data. So the use case given to us is in three parts. Let's understand this, and then we will see where the pivoting comes into play. So they are saying that perform the following step in sequence. First is, if allocation rank is null or blank, then set allocation rank equal to zero. So as of now, I don't see anything, but in case it happens, if anything is null, we have to set it as zero. So as of now, we are good. But anyways, we'll write the code for it, and it seems to be very simple. If it is null or blank, we just have to set it zero. Now, part two, we have to add four columns, rank one, rank two, rank three, and rank four to the data flow with values of allocation rank as, if allocation rank is one, then we have to set rank one as one. And if allocation rank is two, then we have to set rank 2 as 1. So it's rank 2, you can see it's just like a flag which rank is having some value. So if allocation rank is 3, then we have to set rank 3 as 1. So I hope you get it similarly. And we have 4 ranks here. And in the last, we have to set all rank star means rank 1, rank 2, or rank 3, or rank 4. If anything is null, we have to set it as 0. Requirement seems to be clear, I believe, but we'll see how we'll be making an approach towards it. Then third one says, flatten the records by summing up the ranks for each group. Which group? We have to group by these columns. For each group of these columns, we have to sum up rank 1, rank 2, rank 3, and rank 4, whatever we have calculated here. And the sum of these rank has to be in the given target column. So its target rank 1 will be sum of target rank, will be sum of rank 1, target rank 2 will be sum of rank 2, and so on. So if you want to digest the use case, just pause this video and look at this screen for whatever amount of time you want. And if you are good with this, just continue with this video. Let's start with the basic step. And then once we get to the basic minimum, then we will discuss why pivoting and when we should think of pivoting in whatever use case that we want. So let's jump to my IntelliJ. So basically all the schema I have already created, so that we don't waste the time and we are just reading it. Header is true and the delimiter is pipe. Let's just see if we are getting the correct data. Obviously we'll be getting, but it's good to see the output as and when we are doing some coding, so that we can relate the output as and when we are coding. So you can see the same data that I showed you here, we are getting the same. Fine, some allocation ranks are 3, 2, 4. Now you can see as our use case wanted, for such cases we have to set rank 3 as 1, rank 4 as 1, rank 2 as 1. The straight away approach that you might get is very simple. Just do a with column and rank 1 and see what value it has. If it has 3, you somehow with using with column, you set that particular column as 1. But in such cases, you there are, if say there are millions of rows or millions of values having different allocation ranks, it's not practical to write those much with columns. So for that reason, there is a concept of pivoting that will help us in solving this use case. Now first, let's quickly understand what is pivoting in the easiest way possible. So what pivoting does, if you even Google it out the simplest way, you will get that it changes rows into columns. But what it actually is, let's understand. So if we pivot based upon any column, let's say allocation rank is in the question for this use case. Let me take it here on the whiteboard. So let's say if we have an allocation rank, so what pivoting can help us is it can change these values, which are the rows, into different columns. Okay, just the basic idea. So all the twos can go into one column. This can go here, this can go here. All the fours can go into one column. I believe this is all the ones can go into those similar way. So what pivoting, as you can see this curve, what pivoting does is you can mark this as a pivot and all this will go from rows to columns. I believe this is an untidy but clear explanation of pivot. Still, if you don't get it, let me know. Now, what happens when these two fours go into this, but for these two values, what will happen? Do we want the sum of it, the average of it? What do we want of it? That is when the pivot function provides us an aggregation that we can provide. So this was the basic idea behind the pivot. Now, why do we choose pivot for this use case? One reason is, for sure, setting multiple ranks for checking the values of this will compel us to write so many with columns. We want to avoid that. And next, obviously, we want to reduce the amount of code that we write. Now, let's see how we can solve it. So we want to create 4 as rank 1, 2, 3, and in final output, we want target rank 1, 2, 3 as the sum of these ranks. So I have also created a pivot example for you. So let's say this is a sample data that we have with allocation ranks, and these are the target records that we want to have. So all the records still here, but in place of allocation rank, we want rank 1, 2, 3. And there was a clause that set all rank, everything which are null, as 0. So whatever is coming as null, we have to set it 0. This is the target data that we have. And for whatever group of these columns, we have to take sum. So you can see we have for whatever columns we have duplicate data en. You can see the created by en has 3, so there might be 3 records as allocation rank 1. So allocation rank 1 means rank 1 and grouping means 3. So sum of en. I hope you get it. So this is the target records that are requested from us. Similarly here you can see 2. Terry has 2 transactions and they are allocation rank 4. So for Terry we have the target 4 as 2, correct? Because Terry has 4 and he has 2 records. So sum of rank 4, that was 1 plus 1, rank 4, 1 plus 1 is 2. So here 2. This is the target that we want. Whatever I explained, if that was too fast, just pause this video, rewind this video and come back at this point when you get whatever I have explained till now. This was simple but maybe a bit fast. This target final records have to be the result of this complete computation. Now let's code it step by step. So we already have it. Let's comment it out. First condition, if allocation rank is null or blank, then 0. Very simple. Our input ins data dot with column allocation rank, we have to change the value when call of this, call of what, call of allocation rank is null. Or the second condition, let me take it to next line. Or if the second condition, call of allocation rank equal to not zero but blank, then what we have to do is lit of 0. Fine, I messed up here, I don't have to close it. And otherwise we just have to keep the value as call of allocation rank. Okay, so that was pretty simple. The next use case, add 4 columns. Now as we discussed, we want to create 4 columns here with the values. If it is 2, we have to set rank 2 as 1. I have already thought of a pivot solution for this. So what if I do a with column and I create another column, let's say a string for this. Although this allocation rank you can see is a decimal type, but I will create a string type, another column, and in that what I will do, you'll see, I will concat it with lit of rank and then the call of this. So what this will give me, let me assign it somewhere, val processing df, and let's do processing df. See, what this will give me is the same allocation rank with rank concatenated with this rank 2, rank 3, rank 4, and that is what the column that we are being suggested, right? Now as you see that in pivot our rows will get into columns. So now you might be getting the idea why I have done that. Now if I pivot based on the allocation rank str, this rank 1, rank 2, rank 3 will move to the next columns, and we already have the group keys. So let's try doing that and let's see, do we even get that. Let's group on this. We haven't done this yet, but anyways, just trying to do pivot, for that we need grouping. So just taking this, so what we can do, dot group by, and there are multiple rows. Okay, we can create a list of this. Let me edit it. Let's call it a group calls, which will be a list. So this is our, what happened? So these are our group columns. Now group by, how can we group by on a list of column? Actually it takes column then a list of columns. So we can give group calls dot head, then group calls dot tail, followed by everything, because tail is everything apart from head. So group by this. Then we have a function pivot, that is the elephant in the room. Now we want to pivot on this, as we saw, right? We want to create rank 1, rank 2, which are in the allocation rank str. Now what aggregation do you think we should provide? Once we group it and we have to assign one for each as per the use case, okay, and then we have to sum it up. So while our pivoting of ranks, if we just do the counts of ranks, because we have already grouped on this, right? We have already grouped. Now while pivoting on the aggregate, if we just provide the count, it will give the number of rows falling in that group. That's what count does, and that is sort of similar of summing up 1 1 1 for each group, right? So let's try that. Let's give the aggregation function as count. Okay, so you can see we have got ranks. And similarly for Terry, as and when we get the count in that group, it will automatically be telling us the count which will be the sum of 1 1 anyways. So that is automatically using pivot, our next set of instructions got all automatically solved, if you see. Otherwise you might have to do the with columns, then you will have to cast it, giving the conditions like not all the rows will have rank 1, so otherwise allocation rank, then if 2 then rank 2, otherwise allocation rank, somehow 4 statements here, and again the sum for this 4 statements. So 4 and 4, 8 statements we have saved using pivot. But now the hint you can get from here is rank 1, rank 2, rank 4, here itself generating these 4 column itself, we have already achieved this. So there is one advancement that we can again do here. Why do we actually need rank? We can directly append this, right? 1 2 3 4. So what if we do this and now test, and there you go, you get all your final target rank 1, rank 2, rank 3 and rank 4, which are actually the sum of rank 1, rank 2, rank 3. Okay, for 2 you can see, for Terry which had 2 transactions, and for whom you can see the rank was 4, so there is a sum of 2 here in rank 4. But one thing is still pending, that is, let's see our target data. We are getting all this, but still we are getting null. We should be getting 0. So there again, there is a function. You don't need to manually do 0 for all these, suppose there are multiple columns. So let's do one thing, let's take all these columns, let's take it here, make it a list, let's say rank columns, which will be a list of this. So on this we have to replace everything from null to zero, and we have a very beautiful function for that, dot na dot fill. We have to fill 0. Where do we have to fill? In rank columns. Let's test it, and there we have our final output. Okay, So thank you guys for watching this. I hope you liked it. If you really did, please hit that like button and please subscribe to GK Code Labs if you have not already done. Thank you guys. See you later.